So forget any ideas you got about lost cities, exotic travel, and digging up the world. We do not follow maps to buried treasure, and X never, ever marks this spot.
Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I am reviewing four different map animation templates that you can use to punch up your video animations or to use inside of documentaries or any other video work that you are working on. Before we get into the templates, I'm actually going to Skype in Boone from Boone Loves Video, who's become a big map expert. He has a whole playlist called Monday Maps. But before we Skype in Boone, I want to tell you about today's sponsor, Envato Elements. Now, I've been using Envato Elements for a few years now. It has everything you need to become a better video creator. You get unlimited downloads for a small monthly fee. So that means you can test out as many templates, as many stock video, as much music, graphic templates. They have everything you need. And then you can download it to see if it's going to work for your video. And if it doesn't, you can move on and try a different template or a different asset. You don't have to worry about paying for that asset and then being like, oh, it's not gonna work, so I have to go and buy another one. So it's really a fantastic deal. It's a one-stop shop for anything creative that you need for your productions. I use the sound effects. I use some of their graphic templates in Photoshop. I use their After Effects templates, transitions, titles, literally has everything. And Envato Elements has given you 70% off your first month. So if you use my link below, you can get this 70% off special deal. So definitely take advantage of it. And the map animation templates that I'm going to be showing you how to use and review later on in this video are from Envato Elements. But let's say you want to just create a free animation, or you want some more elaborate animations that are not available in Envato Elements. So let's Skype in Boone and let's see what he has to say.
So Boone, you have a ton of videos on map animations. It's almost become sort of like a specialty of yours. For people that maybe don't have an element subscription, or they want to just get some sort of template to use, or if they want to be able to make a map animation for free, or what would you recommend them to do if they're like, oh, I can't afford this, but I just want to be able to make a really quick map animation between two points for free?
What I found, one of the most popular tools that's really a lot of fun, is Google Earth Studio. I've done a couple of videos on that. It works exactly like Google Earth. If you've ever used Google Earth, it's the same. It just allows you to basically do animations. And the really cool thing is that you can export those animations, you can set track points, and then you can bring all that information into Adobe After Effects as an image sequence, and then basically insert graphics and edit around those, which is really amazing.
But what about if somebody wants something more elaborate? What are some templates that you recommend?
Well, my two favorite on Envato Marketplace are created by the same creator. I think it's an Italian guy named Marco, and he created 3D Earth Connections and Map Route Generator, and they kind of work the same way. And the UI is really nice. The panel setup, it's super easy to use. So 3D Earth Connection actually uses Video Copilot's Orb plugin. So you're required to plug that in. That's a free plugin. And obviously it's amazing because it's from Andrew Kramer. So it uses that plugin and then creates all the animations around that. And you really don't have to do much other than plug in your locations. You can plug in cities or countries, and then you can immediately connect all of those, and you can connect multiple, and you can control the animations of how fast you want them to animate or how fast you want the earth to turn. And then Map Route Generator is a very similar tool, but you do it in 3D, but it's with a 2D layer, and then it kind of moves around, and you can control how your little After Effects cam is going to fly around. You can have it follow and turn, or you can have it zoom out. And again, what I like so much about those tools is their usability. They're extremely easy to use.
Yeah, I think that there's a lot of options out there. So we'll put links to Boone's videos down below, but is there anything else for us map nerds out there that we should know?
No, I'm just going to, I'm trying to put out a lot more map content. Like I said, I created a playlist called Monday Maps. So if anybody wants to check that out, it's kind of ranges the spectrum of like whether you're a new user that just wants elements, or whether you want like a super advanced template that's going to do data-driven like population animations. So yeah, if you're interested in that kind of stuff, you know, come check it out.
Thanks, Boone, for joining the Gal channel.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.
So now that we know the free options and some more elaborate options from Envato Market, let's go ahead and go over to Envato Elements and see what 2D and 3D animation templates that we have. I'll be showing how to use them and give them a rating. Let's start with flight maps. Flight maps is one of my favorite templates for After Effects from Elements. It's really easy to create simple 2D animations between two cities fast. First, it has some built-in regional pre-animated maps to choose from. So let's say we wanted to choose Asia. You can just select that box and it will change the default map to the Asia region. You can also select reverse direction if you want to reverse the direction of travel between the two cities. And you can always go back to another map just by reselecting it. It also has 6 different map themes. You can select one of the themes from the template dashboard, and from the effect controls, you can turn on the theme to see how they look. There's flat dark, tech white, lush green, gradients, dots, and watercolor. You can then customize that theme from the effect controls panel. I'm going to leave the water here as white, but I'll change the color of the land to a light green color just by clicking this box. And I'll keep the objects as red, and I'll change the country and state lines to a black color. There's also some cool extra features such as turning on clouds that will add a bit more depth to the map, as well as some dirt textures on top of the map, which I think really adds some more dynamism to the map. And from the template dashboard composition, you can click on the icon layer to choose different options such as a sailboat or a car. I'll go with a car. And you can also customize the pin and the route line style if you like. If you want it to be a solid line, just change the dash slider to 100 and the gap to 0. Next, we can add some cool animation in the opening. Select the transition style layer, then from effect controls, you can turn on one of these transitions. I'll choose the burn, and let's play it back to preview how it looks. And I think this transition looks really cool. It adds a nice little touch to start off the animation. Now onto the important part, let's change the location of our points. All you need to do is double click on the composition frame here and it will open up the map for customization. First, we need to change the camera to be in the correct starting locations. Let's say we're traveling from Madrid, Spain to Warsaw, Poland. Let's go to the camera position, hit P, and select the first keyframe. Now press C on your keyboard multiple times until you get the camera position icon. And from here, you can click and move the map to be over the Spain country. Next, let's go to the second keyframe and do the same and use the camera XY position tool, just like we did before, to move it over Poland. Next, we can just click on the city titles and move them into the correct location. And then you can double click on the title comps and just edit the text to be the correct cities. And then we'll open up the second title comp and let's update it to Warsaw. Now that that's done, it's time to move on to changing the route path. From the route layer, just expand it out to open it, and then open up the content and go to path 1. Select it, and then you will be able to use the selection tool to actually move the first path point to your first location. And then for the second point, you can use the hand tool to move around, and then select V to go back to the selection tool and move the second point over Warsaw. And then you can use the path handles to reshape the path into a nice curved form. You can see that it looks really cool, but the airplane also needs to fly in the right path. To make the airplane follow the path, you're going to go to the main route path layer, and then you're going to click the stopwatch next to path. Then select this new keyframe that was created and hit Control C to copy it. This will copy the path. And then you're going to turn off the stopwatch, which will get rid of that keyframe. Now we're going to go to the airplane layer and select U to expand all the properties. And then we're going to turn off the existing stopwatch next to the existing position keyframes. Then we're going to turn it back on again and press Control V to paste the keyframes from the route path onto the airplane. Then we're going to move these keyframes to align to the timing. And now when we play it back, the airplane is moving on the same path. So I'm going to give this template 4 out of 5 stars, mainly because of all the manual work that you have to do. There's not a panel that just allows you to easily plug in the different cities and it doesn't automatically move for you. But it's really easy to use and it's part of Envato Elements, which makes it super affordable and accessible to a lot of us. Now it's on to the map connector. Map connector is a great 2D template to be able to show metadata or more info about the different locations, but it's not good for connecting two different cities. It's really just great to show different cities and have information pop up. Unlike flight maps, there are no themes to choose from inside of this template. You can see here that there's only one default, but you can select the general settings, and from effect controls, you can customize the map colors. To change the city locations, you need to first open up the destinations composition. And here you can press P to review the position of the camera. And you can change the camera's position to go over the regions or cities that you want to show. First, select 01, the first keyframe here. And then you're going to use the position controls to move the camera over your first location. In our case, it'll be France. And then we're going to select 02 keyframe, the second one, and move it over India. And then we'll do the same for the third one for Australia. And now when we go back to the main composition, you can see that the destinations have been shifted to these new cities or locations that we chose. So to update the text and the info boxes, you actually need to go back to the project panel and open up the different positions to edit them. Then to edit the text, just double click on the info comp you want to edit. And once you've customized the text, you can then go back to the main comp and you can move these keyframes around to control the timing. So if you want the last destination to hold for a longer period, you have to lasso and select these other keyframes and shift them over, and that will hold it for a longer period. So it requires a little bit more work. Overall, it's pretty easy to use. I definitely prefer flight maps over it. I do think that the keyframes are a little bit more difficult to use for beginners, but if you're an intermediate user, you probably should get the hang of it fast. So I'm going to give this 3 out of 5 stars. The next template is called Place on Earth. And if you're looking for a way just to visualize one place using a 3D globe, this is a great template to use. So first, with the edit composition here, you can edit your location. So scrub the comp to the point where you see the city tag appear. This is just the default city tag. It's Las Vegas. And what you can do is double click to change it from Las Vegas to whatever city you want, let's say to Miami. And then I'm going to update the font as well. Then you're going to click on the position layer and simply move it over to Florida on this map. Then you're going to go to the render tab, and from here we can scrub through to see the movement from point 1 to point 2. And right now you can see we're at a quarter resolution, so it doesn't look that great, but it's faster so we can easily edit before we decide to render. So as we scrub through, we can see that we need to update the point 2 parameters so that way Miami is better in frame. To do that, we need to use effect controls. And from here we can go into the point 2 parameters and change the radius so that way we see it better. I'll change it to around 1600, and then the rotation to about 140, and rotation 2 to around minus 20. So you can change all of these parameters and play around with them until it looks right for the city that you're trying to visualize. Now, one thing to note is that these parameters are super sensitive, so just by clicking and scrubbing to a new value, it'll happen really fast and it will be kind of delayed. So definitely try to type in numbers and try to get it right. It's just easier to type versus scrubbing. And there are a few more parameters to choose from. I'll make the color of the label to be pink for Miami, and I'll also change it back to the full resolution, and then I'll fully render it out so that way you can see how it looks. So overall, it's pretty easy to use, but be prepared for a lot of render time because of the 3D animations. I'll give this a 4 out of 5 stars. The only option for map animations in Premiere Pro, not After Effects, is the World Map Toolkit. And this is actually created in After Effects, but exported as a motion graphics template that you can use in Premiere Pro. Now, if you have After Effects, I do not recommend using this template because it's super slow inside of Premiere Pro because it's optimized and created in After Effects. And for some reason, the MoGrit files, when you try to edit them inside of Premiere, there's just a lot of delays. So when you drag and drop the MoGrit file in the timeline and then you go to adjust the parameters, it's just super slow. So if you just have Premiere Pro, I honestly would recommend just investing in After Effects or just getting the trial of After Effects just to use one of the After Effects templates because it's just not worth the pain of using this motion graphics template. I hope in the future that Premiere Pro will optimize itself better to work with more advanced MoGrits from After Effects, but right now, just not worth it. So you can try it out. That's the beauty of Envato Elements is that you can download any of the templates as much as you want and try them out. But I'm using a new Dell computer with 64 gigabytes of RAM and a great GPU, an NVIDIA GPU, and it was still super slow. So those are the 4 templates that are available in Envato Elements. You can search the whole library. They add more templates all the time, so you can go see if there's going to be a new map animation that you can use. But remember that Elements has way more than just these animations. They have music, they have stock video and templates, and what else do they have? Photoshop templates. They even have fonts and textures. It's really, really useful. So use my link below to get 70% off your first month of Elements. And thank you, Envato, for providing that to you guys. And also a huge shout out to Boone for his recommendations as well. Again, his recommendations are linked down below. And now it's time for the comment of the week. Spencer Hogue wrote, "How do I do the same thing with callouts in Premiere Pro?" Now, this question was left on my video on 3 motion tracking effects inside of After Effects. So if you want to track a callout in Premiere Pro, let's say if somebody's running and you want a callout to stay glued on their body as they're moving, you can do that in Premiere Pro, but you need to use a plugin called Mocha Pro by Boris Effects. And basically you install it and it opens up its own window and you can use it. And I've made a whole video on how you can use Mocha Pro to track objects to moving objects in Premiere. But if you want to have a faster performance, I would recommend still using After Effects because you can actually take a clip from Premiere Pro and use Dynamic Link to open it up in After Effects, do the tracking in After Effects, and then once you hit save, whatever you did in After Effects appears in Premiere Pro. So if you added a call out, you'll then see that in Premiere. So I think that's a really good workflow, is to continue to use Premiere Pro for the editing. And then, you know, when you need to add an effect, just cut that clip and send it over to After Effects using Dynamic Link and do the tracking in After Effects because it's more powerful for doing that type of thing. So I hope that answers your question. Spencer, thanks so much for asking. And if you guys have any other questions for a future video, just leave a comment below. And yeah, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. You map nerds, enjoy these map animations. Take advantage of Elements to spice up your next video. See you guys next time. Bye.